Hey, it's Blake at DD Audio. We got a ton of questions about the Z12K amplifier. I wanted to go into some of the big engineering decisions that shaped it and make it what it is. The theme here is uncompromising performance, and we've got a Z12K power supply board to show off some of the stuff. First off, why 12,000 watts? Well, for a large variety of reasons, with current semiconductor technology, the practical output limit for a half-bridge amplifier is 15,000 watts at 1 ohm. You can go higher, but that requires using the same devices and just running them harder, which reduces stability. But this is 15,000 watts at the maximum charging voltage. Since we chose to make the Z12K 16 volt stable, that results in 12,000 watts at 14.4 volts at 1 ohm. So why 16 volt? Why not 17 or even 18 volt? It's easy to make the amp 17 or 18 volt stable. You just take a couple wraps off the transformer, reduce the rail voltage. The problem is that you're reducing power. Remember, the limit is 15,000 watts at the highest charging voltage. If we made the Z12K 17 volt stable, then it would only make 10,500 at 14.4 and only 13K at 16 volt. Going to 18 volt stable would lose even more power at those lower voltages. You don't really gain anything with the higher input voltages, you just lose output in the charging ranges that work best with modern lithium. Now moving on, quad inputs. These have a ton of benefits, so let's get into it. The most obvious advantage to quad inputs is that it splits the load, allowing for more input wires for more efficiency and better voltage. Triple inputs simply can't handle the current that a Z12K is capable of drawing. There are other benefits and drawbacks as well. The biggest drawback is cost and size. The quad inputs mandate a much larger heatsink that's far more expensive to make and ship, and of course takes up more space. But the larger heatsink also provides better heat dissipation and absorption, so it's difficult to say that's a bad thing. Now, triple inputs would save a ton of money, making the retail of the price of the amp several hundred dollars less, but the amplifier would not perform as well, so we paid extra for the quad inputs. The less well-known benefit to quad inputs is it allows for a fully symmetrical power supply. Lots of people ask why we have alternating power and ground instead of all the positives on one side, all the negatives on the other. This is why. Bit of basic electronics, when power goes through a wire, you have voltage drop. The longer the wire, the more voltage drop. Voltage drop inside of a power supply causes ringing, which can very quickly destroy the MOSFETs if it gets too severe. Having the power on one side and ground on the other results in longer and different trace lengths to each of the transformers, meaning that each one is seeing a different voltage. This hurts efficiency, power output, and reliability. You can see on the back of the board here that these two 12 volt inputs are supplying power through this giant bus bar to these four transformers here, and it's exactly the same on the other side. This keeps everything balanced for maximum efficiency, power, and reliability. Also, with the large PCB, we staggered the transformers to pack them as close together as we could to again ensure the most even voltage between them. Having all the power on one side and ground on the other is more convenient for installs, but the amplifier wouldn't work as well, so we alternate the power and ground. There's hundreds more engineering decisions that go into an amplifier like the Z12K, and they all add up to the final performance of the amplifier. These are a few of the big ones, but if y'all have any more questions, feel free to ask in the comments and we'll make sure to answer. Have a good one, y'all.